Hi, everybody. For this week's Devo, we'll be looking at Ephesians 4, verse 15, which says, rather, speaking the truth in love. That's the phrase I want to center in on, but let's look at it. Speaking the truth in love, we're to grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ. Now, before I pull and look at this little phrase, we need to understand it as a context. Paul is talking about unity in the church, and he's using the metaphor of the church as the body of Christ. So Christ is the head, he's in control, he's over us all, and we're the body. Believers are different parts of the body of Christ, different personalities, different giftings, different offices and roles, and yet all together, and we're to maintain the unity together. And one of the ways we do that is by speaking the truth in love. That helps us avoid doctrines that might separate us by mistakes. It also helps us to grow in maturity, whereby we learn how to love each other more deeply and forgivingly and understand better what Christ is calling us to do. Those things are true, but I just want to take now time to look at that phrase, speak the truth in love, because I think there's so much there for us to work on, because it's really, really hard. And I believe that when the Bible calls us to do hard things, it's calling us to something with great potential for good. So let's look at how we can speak the truth in love better and be a great blessing to those around us. Because many of us are good at speaking the truth, but not so much in love. We like to be right, but sometimes our tongues become like whips, lashing people with the truth, hurting people with the truth. It should never be that way. Yes, we should speak the truth, but we should do it in loving ways to others. And love softens what might be a difficult truth to hear and accept. And so when we speak the truth to people, we should do it in such a way where we really consider, well, how can I love the person enough to help them to hear this difficult truth? How can I soften this by a loving presentation of the truth? Others of us speak very loving words, but they lack the truth because we don't want to have a conflict. We don't want to stir the pot, or we want to be polite. But I want to suggest to us that that love needs to be tempered with the truth. We need to love people enough to speak the truth to them. Truth is what gives our communication real meaning. And I think sometimes we avoid and sacrifice truth at the altar of keeping the peace, not simply for the sake of the other person, but I think a lot of the times we do that for us because we don't want the trouble of speaking the truth and having conflict. But we need to love people enough to speak the truth to them. It's this wonderful balance of speaking the truth and loving them at the same time. How do we keep ourselves in the middle? We got to know our inclinations, and we got to keep checking ourselves. Am I speaking the truth? Am I doing it with love? It's a wonderful thing. Now, I like to think about this as sanctifying the conversations that we have. We want to bring the Holy Spirit into our conversations. We want to actively remember how he's trying to influence us and our conversations in that moment. We want to invite him in. And we can do that, by, even if it's just us and not the other person. We can do that through a number of means. We want to develop a habit. I want to suggest some questions. Asking yourself, well, how can I build the other person up? Because that's what love wants. It wants to bring the other person to maturity. How can I build the other person up? How can I help them to understand more truth through this conversation? How can I speak the truth lovingly in this conversation? And how can this person experience God's love and God's truth through me in this moment? So I see myself as a vehicle for God's truth and God's love whenever I'm talking or interacting with another person. Now, this takes work because it's not our natural self. Our natural self, we fall into sinful habits. And quite frankly, if we're not paying attention, believers, we have been regenerated. We've been given a new self. But as Paul will shortly go on to say, we still have that old self that's got to be put off, and we've got to live into the salvation and the regeneration that God has given us through Christ. So we need to work on this. It's not easy. And it's particularly hard these days. I think our patience is a little bit frayed because the pressures and circumstances of life these days, things are abnormal. Things are challenging and difficult. And so we need to work on it that much more. And I want to make two caveats. First, this isn't just face-to-face communication. If it were, it wouldn't apply to too many people. It includes Zoom. And when we're talking to people online, we need to work harder because it's harder to pick up people's reads. It's more tiring, I think. So you need to work harder at making sure you're being loving in your communication. And also, especially online, with short communications that people are posting stuff online, it's so easy to be misunderstood. Really think, is this the truth and is it a loving truth? Because a lot of online communication is nasty, but we shouldn't be like them. We're called to be different. The other aspect I want us to consider is family. We're many of us, not all of us, but many of us are in these closed spaces. We're stuck at home, isolating ourselves with family. And because they're family, they're closer to us. We can get a little bit more careless with our words. We figure, they understand. They know I love them anyway. But don't think that way. Yes, when you speak to someone that's closer to you, there's less formality. But I would suggest to you, you have to be even more loving, even more careful with the truth you speak. Because think about this. If someone insults me that is a stranger, it doesn't mean much to me. But if someone I genuinely love insults me, it hurts and wounds that much deeper. And because of that negative power, there's also an opposite positive power. When if a stranger speaks something kind to me, I appreciate it. But when someone loves that I love speaks kindly to me, it builds me up and it blesses me that much more. Use this opportunity to speak loving truth to your family, to really work at that, to be that just blessing of God's love and truth into their lives at this time. And finally, give yourself grace in it, because you're going to mess up. You're going to have to apologize sometimes, but get back up on your feet and keep working at speaking the truth in love. But how do we do that? You can't bring God's truth and God's love into the situation without God. So make sure you are praying a lot, and make sure you are reading and spending time with God every day with the one who is the truth and who is love, so that you can bring that love and truth into your interactions with others. May God bless you and help you to speak the truth in love this week to those around you.